गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर फर्स्ट बायोलॉजी क्लास, दैट इज लेसन 3, प्लांट लाइफ फोटोसिंथेसिस। नाउ व्हाट इज फोटोसिंथेसिस? एज वी ऑल रिक्वायर्ड फूड इन द सेम वे प्लांट ऑल्सो रिक्वायर्ड फूड, दे प्रिपेयर द फूड इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ फोटोसिंथेसिस। द टर्म फोटोसिंथेसिस वॉज फर्स्ट यूज बाय बार्न्स इन 1898। It is a common method by which green plants make their food. Why green? Because for making a food, chlorophyll is must, and chlorophyll is present in the green plants. Now, as we all required food, all required nutrition, in the same way, green plants also require their food, they require their nutrition, but they take their nutrition in the form of a process called photosynthesis. And the raw material, the important things which is required for the plant to make the food is carbon dioxide, water, and there is a pigment present in the green leaves that is called as chlorophyll. And the capacity of chlorophyll is to stain the sunlight into complex chemical reaction so that a food can be produced. And later on, the food is produced with the help of these raw material. So at last, what we can say, that what is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is a process by which green plants make their food with the help of carbon dioxide, water, and chlorophyll in the presence of sunlight. You have to mention the term chlorophyll, which is extremely important. Then comes your, in the picture you can see that the plants is taking water from the clouds or from the rain, or sometimes we also give water. Water is present in the soil, the sunlight is giving energy, and there are chlorophyll is present in the leaves. And later on, by the process of photosynthesis, the plant can prepare its own food. Now in your book, there are certain activities given. Those activities I will be explaining you later on. Now, the main event that occurred during the process of photosynthesis can be as a summarized as absorption of light energy by chlorophyll molecule. What light energy? The sunlight energy is absorbed by your chlorophyll. Conversion of light energy to chemical energy, splitting of water molecules, and so that it can change into hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen and oxygen means, here you can see there is a chemical formula given. Carbon dioxide and water makes glucose. Glucose is a food which is required by the plant to make the food. And then oxygen and water is given out. Food is given out, oxygen is given out, and water is given out as a end product. Then plant utilize carbon dioxide released by the animals and convert it into useful oxygen, which is again used by the plant during photosynthesis. Now, where photosynthesis occur? What are stomata? As we have already told, photosynthesis occurs in the leaves of the plant. But as we all know, the leaves have a small microscopic opening which is present on the surface of the plant and which allow the easy passage of the water vapor, carbon dioxide and oxygen. There are small spores, there are small tiny spores, holes in the leaves, which allow water, carbon dioxide and oxygen to come inside or go outside. They are crucial to the function of the leaves. At photosynthesis require plenty of carbon dioxide, as well as it release a waste product, oxygen. Now, our oxygen is a waste product for the plant, but at the same time, oxygen is very important for us. Stomata means here holes, or stomata means mouth in a Greek language. The main site of stomata on a leaf surface, but they are found in all other parts of the plant, our part of the plant. The number of stomata present in the plant depend upon the environmental condition. That means the plant, when maximum amount of water is present, the number of stomata will be more, and where the water is less, the number of stomata will be less. Then their numbers increase in better environmental condition to maximize the rate of photosynthesis. In warmer environment, particularly dry areas, plant lose large amount of water. The stomata in such condition, stomata close and rate of photosynthesis decreases. This is done by the plant to save their water resources. Now, what is the mechanism? How the stomata open and closes? The opening and closing of stomata is regulated by the turgidity of the guard cell. Now, what is turgidity? Turgidity means filling of the guard cell by water. The stomata are open when the guard cell are turgid. On losing the turgidity, the stomata get closed. Now, in the picture, you may see at the top that this is a white gap. This white gap is called a stomata. It is open stomata. And this is closed. That means it is closed stomata. Now, what is flaccidity and turgidity? Turgidity means when these guard cell is full of water, it open the stomata. And when they do not have water, they close the stomata. And when it is full of water, we called it as turgid guard cell. And when it is less of water, we called it as flaccid guard cell. Now, what is the structure of stomata? Stoma means gap. Stoma has two bean guard cells. They have inner thick wall as compared to the outer wall. When the guard cell are full of water, we call it turgid. It swells and open outside where the stoma open. Here you can see the structure properly. These are the guard cell, and when these guard cell are full of water, they open the stomata, and when the guard cell are closed, the stomata is also closed. So when the guard cell lose water, they lose their turgidity and stomata close. Now, what is the function of stomata? Stomata helps in exchange of gases between the leaves and the atmosphere. It helps the process of transpiration. This much you have to read it properly, and you have to answer the exercises which I will be posting. Okay, boys.